With the digital era, I really feel that the method of education has to become more about self-learning than imposed learning. And we are now seeing, lectures and lectures are being given in the college, which is of the content that the students can get themselves from the best of the faculty in the world, from Stanford, Massachusetts Institute, IIT also has put their courses. So in that context, what is the role of faculty members like yourself who have been doing that for so many years? So for that, I have an idea I want to share with you. And before I do that, because unsolicited advice is poisonous, so I don't want to give unsolicited advice. I want to check your response right now using digital media. Even if five people say, yes, we want to hear the idea, then only I will share. Otherwise, Darshan bhai can take over. So please use the chat button and say, yes, we want your idea, then only I will share. I am not seeing the chat. Oh my God. Okay. Oh, okay. All right. Thank you. Thank you. I really bow down to your openness. So the idea is something that I have tried in the visit as a guest lecture. I go to, as I told you, not only to SS Gandhi, but to SEPT Ahmedabad also, and to Nirma also, and to MIT University, both campuses, Bombay, as well as this Noida. And everywhere I have started using a technique, and Darshan bhai knows that because whenever he invites me, I use that technique with him also. And that is what I called the question technique. Question technique is basically before we give the lecture or before we give the knowledge, we make the student very curious about that, where they are now thirsty or hungry for the answer. Just like I checked with you whether you are curious or not, and so many people said yes, much more than the five that I wanted. I think more than 20 people responded. So why you responded? Because the question made you curious. That was the example I wanted to tell you, that if we ask question in a way where the curiosity of the student is instigated, or they get that feeling of knowing, then they will automatically go and read the chapter before you have to tell them, or they will go on Google and try to find example. Or sometimes the question that you can ask is based on practical thing, where you can say, can you go and talk to three people in the industry who are using the same knowledge in their day-to-day practice? Like the madam just now asked question about bar bending. If you ask question, can you go on three construction site and find out who is making the bar bending schedule, what is the format, and who is the one who is using that bar bending schedule to cut the steel? Just simple thing, in 20, 30 minutes of site visit, anybody can find out. But this will give the curiosity to them. And that way they will become on self-learning mode, where they get a habit of grasping new information, evaluating it in themselves. And then when you are teaching, you will be so happy that the students have come prepared. The students actually want to learn what you are going to present. And you will also feel satisfaction. Maybe some of the things they bring to the class from their old exploration will even give you new idea and new information, which may otherwise not be available to you. So that was my idea. And I am giving this from my personal experience in taking visiting lectures. So it is not that I have not tested this idea, just your quick response is validation of that. But why I am giving it is with a simple reason that knowledge and the ability to grasp knowledge and use it in practical way is becoming more important today than only knowledge. And in the last 22 years since I graduated, I have seen how much fast things changing. Just quick joke. When I was a student in 9th standard, now my son is in 9th standard. So when I was in 9th standard, Pluto was part of solar system. Today's book says Pluto is not part of solar system. So how changing, simple things are changing. Nothing actually changed in solar system, but the definition changed. Knowledge changed. Similarly, in engineering also, some of the formula are changing. Material science is advancing so fast. 3D computing is coming in so fast. lot of simulation techniques are coming so fast, it is very difficult to keep up with it. So the only way to teach or to prepare these students for the future is that make them curious people. Curious people so they can find the answer themselves. If they have curiosity, you will help them get to where they want, but by giving birth to curiosity, you will train them for the rest of their lives. That is all from my side. I am very much available on LinkedIn, and I am very, you can see how much I use it for even making simple decisions. And my LinkedIn profile is Sumant Kachru. You can just Google it. I mean, LinkedIn search it and you will find me. I look forward to interacting with you. And I am, as I said, it is my passion to share and make it better for the students. So any one of you, even other than this program, FDP program, has any reason to interact with me, want to share your idea, or you have any good students you want to benefit from internship at my organizations or do thesis under me. I'm also guide for MIT Noida campus and for SEPT. These two places thesis students come to me. So more than welcome. Of course, I can handle only so much. So I only take the topic which are also of interest to me. But even if the student comes, at least I will introduce to somebody in my network who may be interested in guiding. So feel free to be in touch with me. Thank you again.